Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and now that we have a pretty good understanding of what the bones are that make up the pelvic girdle, now we can talk a little bit about where these bones articulate and what joints are going to be formed and what type of joints will be associated. And so the two main joints that we are going to discuss are the paired sacroiliac joints and the pubic symphysis, which is found in the midline region. And then we'll talk a little bit about the ligaments associated with both of these joints and what happens and what would be the function of relaxation of some of these ligaments, particularly in terms of during pregnancy or the latter portions of pregnancy. Okay, so the sacroiliac joints, these are going to be between the auricular surfaces of the coxal bones, as well as the auricular surfaces of the sacrum. And honestly, both of these surfaces kind of look like little ears. They look like this shape, and they will articulate with the auricular surface of the other bone. And as you can see, there are two sacroiliac joints, so these are paired because you have two coxal bones. Now, what is neato about these sacroiliac joints are that these are what's considered compound joints, meaning that you really have two joints in one. In this case, you have two different structural types of joints in one area. So you will have a synovial portion of the sacroiliac joint that will honestly be the more anterior portion, which we can't see quite as well here, and synovial really will make up the majority of it. And then this more posterior portion back here will actually be a syndesmosis. And think back to our conversations regarding the joint basics. What type of joint is a syndesmosis? Oh, remember, it's a good old fibrous joint. So we have both a fibrous joint and a synovial joint associated with the sacroiliac joint. Now, it is a synovial joint. Synovial joints, as we know, are freely movable. But when we're talking about the sacroiliac joint, we have it's kind of pretty closely locked into place. You have some very, very strong ligaments that really, really, really limit the movement that's allowed at sacroiliac joints. You have a little bit. You want some flexibility in order to be able to move your hip a little bit, but you don't want too much because there is a lot of weight bearing that's associated with the pelvic girdle. So you don't want to have, with movement, you often will lose stability. So this is a very, these are very stable joints. And so with that, very little movement is allowed. The pubic symphysis is exactly what you would think it is because it has it right here in its name. It is a symphysis, which is a cartilaginous joint. And so you'll have the two symphyseal surfaces of the pubic bones articulating, and then you will have the cartilaginous portion that is actually attaching these two bones together. So you only have the one pubic symphysis, and it's right here in the midline like most of the other symphyses. And little movement is allowed here as well. Okay, so this is an old image. I think it's from Gray's Anatomy, a very, very older version. But I really like how it's showing the complexities and the amount of ligaments that you have in these areas, particularly in association with the sacroiliac joint. There's a lot going on in that region. But with increased levels of hormones, and particularly estrogen, relaxin is going to be an important one in that latter half of the pregnancy, these ligaments are going to become what we like to refer to as relaxed, all right? So it's causing relaxation associated with the ligaments, and that gives a bit more mobility to the joints in this region. And this can even allow an increase in diameter of certain components of the pelvic girdle. So particularly in terms of that pelvic outlet, if you have some flexibility in some of these ligaments down here, that can really serve to widen or increase the diameter of that pelvic outlet, and this will help to facilitate the passage of the fetus through the pelvic canal. So anything that's kind of increasing that area will help with that movement there. All right, so those are the joints associated with the pelvic girdle. Again, we will, of course, have the ball and socket hip joint, but we'll talk about that with the lower limb as it's really going to affect the movement of that region more. But with the joints that we were talking about here, we have an example of all the main structural types of joints. So we had a fibrous joint, a cartilaginous joint, a synovial joint. Which one of the joints did we discuss is cartilaginous? Is it the pubic symphysis or the sacroiliac joint? And hopefully you remember, I'm so excited, I can't wait to underline this. So you remember cartilaginous, the symphysis is a type of cartilaginous joint. And so the pubic symphysis is cartilaginous. The sacroiliac is fulfilling the other two. So that's syndesmosis. So you have a syndigmatic part, which is fibrous joint, as well as a synovial joint portion. So you have that compound sacroiliac joint. All right, excellent. Let's finish our conversation of the pelvis, talking about certain muscles, particularly those that may play a role in terms of the lower limb. Some of the muscles for this region will also be discussed in the reproductive section of the course. Thank you for your time and attention, and as always, I hope you have a lovely rest of your day.